Hello students, meeting of the day. In the last lecture, we have discussed the data abstraction with the help of different examples that how we can implement the abstraction. And in the same lecture, we discussed the various class and objects, right? And how we can implement the data abstraction in our C++ language. So while discussing that abstraction, we come to know that to implement this type of data abstraction, we require three different types of process specifiers. Right? So we can make our data the class networks public, or we can make them private, we can make them protected. Right? So how we are going to implement such a kind of abstraction in our class that we discussed, right? So in today's lecture, with respect to that data abstraction, we are going to discuss our process specifiers in detail. So in today's lecture, we are also going to discuss these process specifiers that we discussed in the last lecture, that how we are going to implement those process specifiers. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss the same process specifiers in more detail. Okay, so let us start with the process specifiers. So first of all, how we can define the process specifiers? Okay, so process specifiers are going to be defined, or we can define the process specifiers as, we can say that these are going to define how the data members are going to be accessed by the other classes or outside the classes, right? So process specifiers defines that how the members of class are going to be accessed in the code, right? Of ID. So we can say that here that in the same class, with the same class of outside class. Okay? Outside class. So with the help of these process specifiers, we are going to specify that how the members of that class are going to be accessed. So obviously we want to have a particular members of class. In class, we are going to have the attributes, and we are going to have the different member functions. Right? So, with the help of the process specifiers, we are just going to specify how we are going to define that how the attributes and member functions of that class are going to be accessed. Right? So, in the last lecture, we just have discussed one example. That is class, my class. Okay, so we can see this example. In that, you can just mention the public and another public. You can specify or you can define your attributes and member functions that you want to be accessible by the other member functions or other classes. Okay, so you can just use this public view. So this public is nothing but your process specifier. This is nothing but your process specifier, under which all the methods and the attributes that you have defined are going to be made as a public, right? Or which are going to be made accessible to the other member functions and other classes. So, with respect to such a kind of example, you can either use public access specifier, then we are having the private access specifiers. In the last lecture, we already have discussed, that is, we are having three types of process specifiers, public, private, and the third one is protected, right? Protected. So, whenever you are going to have the and the attributes under this public, these methods and these attributes are going to be assessed by the other classes or the outside your class. Then this is nothing but private, right? It is private. It is not going to allow to assess the attributes and the data members that we have defined or declared in this private assess specifier. Then they are highly protected. Okay? The third type. Here the public, what we are going to do, it is going to allow assess from outside class. From inside and outside class. Outside class. This is also one of the private, also one of the assess specifier. It is not going to allow assess. To use attributes like functions, member functions, instead of member functions, I am just writing functions, right? And in this protected, what we are going to do? With the help of this protected, it is also not allowing to possess the member functions and the attributes, right? Not allowed, but right? It is not going to allow to use the attributes and the member functions outside the class. But if it is inherited, right? It allows to the inherited classes, right? Inheritors, if we are going to implement inheritors, right? So it is going to allow. Allowed to inherited access. Okay? Means in protected, the member functions under that protected access specifier and the attributes that are declared under the protected access specifiers are not going to be allowed to the other classes. But if the class in which you have just define or use that assess specifiers is inherited by the other class, right? At that time, that other class can use these protected member functions or the attributes that we have defined under this protected keyword. Okay, so these are nothing but the three important members, we can say that we can have as an assess specifiers in our program, right? So in public, this is a specifier which allows to use the data members and the member functions from outside the class. In private, you are not going to be allowed to use the data members from outside the class. In protected, you are not allowed to use such a kind of data members from the outside the class. If that class is inherited from the class, at that time we can just use this protected keyword, and you can make use of the all the members and data members that we have defined under this protected, and you can make use of them. Okay, so let us try to understand that how it is going to be work. In last lecture we already have discussed. Today's lecture, we will see one simple example, and with the help of that example, we are just going to try to understand that how it is going to be implemented. So, let us that we are having one my class. Okay, in that my class, we are having process specifier of integer x. Then if I am having the private class in that integer y. Okay. We are just having the data members. Similarly, you can just assume the member functions, right? So we can first of all have the member functions which are defined below this public keyword, right? So this is nothing but our class. I just have defined or declared the variables, one is of integer type and another is of one is of our public and another is of private. Okay, so public one and private one. So I am going to have the main function. Integer main. In that, I am just going to create one object for this class. My class object. With the help of this integer main, I am just going to assign both the variables, integer x and integer y. How we can perform this? So, object dot x is equal to k. Right? Then, object dot y is equal to 20. Return 0. Two variables. Right? You can assume that in the program we already have included all the header files of the library files that we have. Okay. So this is nothing but the main function. Whenever this program is going to be executed, it is going to throw and error, right? Because we are going to create the object of this my class. Okay? But whenever this object is going to call, the x variable is over the value there. At that time, it is going to be so an error that the variable we are having x as an object. So the value x is going to be value k is going to be assigned to this variable x. But at the second time, whenever we are going to have object of y is equal to 20. Right? So this integer by variable is a private member of our class, my class, right? Which is not accessible by the that class, or which is not accessible by that your program. At that time, it is going to throw an error, that is, object.y is not accessible, right? That method or that variable data member is not going to be accessed by the your object or by your code, right? So likewise, you can perform the data abstraction with the help of the access specifiers that we are having, first is public, second is private, and the one that we are having, that is nothing but protected. That protected, we are going to discuss whenever we are going to go through the inheritance part. At that time, obviously, this protected keyword is going to be from inter programs. At that time, obviously, we are going to discuss that how this protected assisted is going to work. Okay? So, this is nothing but the assist specifiers that we can use to implement the abstraction, data abstraction, and the data heading of the information heading. Okay. This is the name of process state. Okay. So we can conclude today's topic with the table in which you can just identify that what type of data is accessible in which conditions. Okay. So we are having the assess specifiers, right? Then three assess specifiers are there. Public, second is private, and third is protected. So that can be assessed. Assess specifiers are going to allow us or going to specify that how that data is going to be assessed in inside class, right? In the same class, okay? We can say that in the same class, then outside class and in derived class, Okay. So we are creating public access specifier. The public access specifier is going to allow to access the data members or the member functions inside the class. It is also allow to access those data members and member functions outside the class and also in the derived class, because these data members are the member functions are declared as a public. So here we can say that accessible, right? Accessible. Now we are having private, right? We are having private. In private, the data members and the data members and your member functions are going to be accessed inside the class. Inside the same class, you can make use of those data members, but outside the class, you cannot make. So here, we are able to access outside class, obviously not accessible. In derived class also not accessible. Okay. Now we are ready. Protected. The third one. In protected, what we are going to do? Inside the class, obviously not access. Right. Then in outside class is protected and not going to be accessed. And outside, in the derived class, we can access. I think inside class, we can access this protected member functions. Let me check once. If it is protected, yes, we can access. Okay. If the data members are protected, but inside the same class, we can make use of those protected data variables and the member functions inside your same class. But if you are accessing those data members and member functions from the outside class, it is not possible. You cannot make use of those data members and the member functions from outside class. Right? But if you are trying to use those data members and member functions from outside the class, which are derived from your base class, at that time, it is again going to follow you to use those data members and member functions from outside class also. Those classes are obviously called as derived class. Okay. So this is the thing about the access specifiers. Public access specifiers, private access specifiers, and protected access specifiers. And this is the thing about how we are going to assess or which data is accessible and in which condition it is not going to be accessed, that we have just specified with the help of this diagram or with the help of this table. Okay. So this is all about our access specifiers. Okay. So today we are going to end our session. The next lecture or in the next session we are going to discuss another topic. Okay. So today we are going to end our session. Thank you very much.